Hey there, my name's James. I'm the author of Airbnb for Dummies. I'm an Airbnb expert, and over the last 4 years now, I've been managing properties on Airbnb. I've been working with properties and managing with property owners in all kinds of different countries all over the world, cities big and small, and so I'm a bit of an expert when it comes to managing properties on Airbnb. Now, in today's video, I'm going to talk to you about one of the most commonly asked questions that I get asked all the time for people who watch my videos and who, you know, check out my stuff, is that they want to know, how do I pitch a property owner and get them to let me manage their property without paying any money out front out of my pocket? I don't want to pay for rent. I don't want to pay for anything, furniture, none of that. And how do I pitch a property owner and get them to say yes? So in this video, we're going to talk about exactly that. I'm going to break down for you a couple things. So we're going to start with, you know, why do property owners actually want to manage their properties on Airbnb? Why do they want to have them on Airbnb in the first place? Why would they want to do that? We're going to talk about why they would want you to manage their property as opposed to managing themselves or having anyone else manage the property. Why do they want you to manage that property for them? And I'm going to talk to you guys about how you can present this to property owners in such a way that 80% of the property owners you meet with are going to say yes, it's going to be a total no-brainer for them to work with you and have you manage their property. So by the end of this video, you're going to have a really clear idea of exactly what you need to do when you meet with a property owner to make sure that they say yes to having you manage their property on Airbnb. Now, in case you're wondering why you'd even want to do this, you can check out the link below in the description that's going to link to some other videos that I did that I put together and put on YouTube here that are going to walk you through exactly why you'd want to do this and how you can earn $700 to $1,200 per month managing properties on Airbnb. That's for each property. So how you can earn a full-time income managing other people's properties on Airbnb, link to that video in the description below. But if you've already gone through that or you already understand that part of it and you want to know how do you actually pitch the person, the property owner, so you get that property owner management, then you're in the right place. So let's go ahead and get started. And the place I want to start off with is really foundational, it's super important, is I want to address a big mistake that people make. Is that the question people always ask me is, how do I pitch this property or how do I convince them to let me manage their property? And that is fundamentally the worst question, the wrong question for you to be asking yourself at this stage. If you're going into this with a mindset of how do I convince them, that's got an undertone of how do I mislead them? How do I, you know, I don't care if it's in their best interest. I just want to know how do I convince them to let me do it. And ultimately, you might be able to have some sleazy sales pitch that's going to win over a couple property owners, but you're never going to keep those properties long term unless you're actually adding real value to them and creating a win-win scenario. And so that's where I really want to start with, is why would a property owner want to put their property on Airbnb, and why would it be beneficial to them that you manage the property? So rather than coming at this from a standpoint of convincing the property owner, we really want to look at it from a standpoint of, how do we make this a win-win? How do we make this a benefit to them? How do we point that out? So let's start from there. So to start with, why would a property owner want to put their property on Airbnb? Now, some property owners you're going to meet with will have already done this. They already have their property on Airbnb, and it's just a matter of you managing it for them. Other property owners are going to be, you know, listing their property for a long-term rental, and so it's going to need some work to show them why they would actually want to put their property on Airbnb. And there's three reasons for this, primarily with most property owners that you'll meet with. The first reason is money. You can make a lot more money in virtually every market around North America, Europe, Australia, these major markets. You can make more money by listing the property on Airbnb than you can on long-term rental. Now, there is some upfront expense to that of getting the property furnished, but the ROI on that investment for the property owner is typically quite huge, right? They can make their money back, you know, twofold, threefold over the course of a year, so it's a pretty good ROI for them. Now, this is true of most markets, big and small, whether you're in a rural area, whether you're in a big metropolitan area, wherever you are, you can typically make more money, so that's one of the driving factors for most property owners. I'm going to show you a tool later in this video as well. I'm going to link to it in the description so that you can actually show a property owner how much more they could be earning on Airbnb as well, just so that in case they really want the data behind that, which a lot of property owners will, you can actually show them. So number one is money. Number two is control. A lot of property owners want to have more control than what it allows them when they have a long-term tenant in there. depending on where the property is located, there's going to be different laws and different regulations around the landlord and tenancy relationship and agreement that they've got there. And so property owners are limited in what they can do with that property if they have a 12-month long-term tenant in there. You can't just evict them. You can't just kick them out of there. You can't use the property for whatever you want. You can't always do the renovations that you want to do. It can be really costly, all these different factors. And so having the additional control of not having someone in there long-term who's signed on to a long-term lease can be really nice and beneficial to a lot of property owners. And the third one is visibility. Being able to go in there when they please in between guests and check out the property, make sure it's in good condition, look at the guest reviews from wherever they might be in the world and see that yes, this property is being well maintained, it's being well taken care of, these guests are clearly happy. That's another added bonus to a lot of property owners. So those are the reasons why they'd want to put their property on Airbnb. Now, why would they want to work with you? So what problem does it create when they put their property on Airbnb that you would want them to solve, or that they would want you to solve rather, and how do we actually go about the pitch? How do we present this to them so that they're actually gonna want to work with you? Well, typically there's two problems that property owners have with listing the property themselves on Airbnb. So this is where you're gonna be at once you've convinced a property they wanna be on Airbnb and you show them that that is actually the best course of action for them. Or if you're meeting with someone who already has figured that out and they're already listing the property themselves on Airbnb, they're gonna hit a roadblock, right? They're gonna realize that to do that, they don't know how to maximize returns, number one. And number two, they don't have the time to be able to put into doing all this themselves, you know, messaging the guests, managing the cleaners, all that sort of thing. And so the first step is gonna be, you know, let's take care of that time side of things. Let's talk about that first. So it's quite easy to be able to show them that, hey, I can do all this. The solution for it's pretty simple. I'll do it all for you. I'll take care of it. And then I'll do a really good job of it. And so you have to have the right strategy and the right approach to be able to do that. Pro tip, rather than telling them that you're going to do a great job, just show them. One of the things that we do all the time with our property owners is we do what's called a 3-month trial period. So when I'm meeting with a property owner and I'm explaining to them that, okay, I'll take care of the guest communication, I'll take care of the cleaning, I'll take care of all this, and I'll do a really great job. But look, you don't have to trust me that I'll do a really great job of this and just go on blind faith and sign some long agreement. Let's do a 3-month trial period. If within those first 3 months of me managing the property, you're not happy with the work that I'm doing for any reason at all, just let me know. I'll hand the property back to you. I'll charge you the management fee up until the time that I stop managing it. And beyond that, it's back to you. If I've got extra bookings in the calendar beyond that, then you know, you're canceling within that trial period, no stress. You can just keep those bookings. I'm confident I'm gonna do a really great job, and I'd rather just show you than try to convince you and shove something down your throat. Now, saying that does two things. It's really amazing what this can do. If you give that trial period, it de-risks it for them, which we're going to talk about a little bit later about why this is, it leads into why property owners 80% of the time are going to say yes, it's going to be a no-brainer. And it shows that you're really confident. It shows that you actually know what you're talking about and know that you're committed to doing a great job, because otherwise you wouldn't be saying that. Otherwise you'd want to sign them into some long-term agreement where they've got to, you know, sign on with you for a year or longer. But by having the confidence to say, hey, look, I'm gonna do a great job, let me just show you rather than tell you, it instills a lot of confidence in the property owner. Now, the next thing you wanna talk about with them is the money. You wanna show them how you can help them to earn more money. Now, obviously, if the property owner has their property on long-term rent, this is a lot easier to do, right? Because the numbers are just gonna make sense. But with a property owner who already has their property listed on short-term rental, you have to be realistic and you have to show them exactly how much more they can earn. And in some cases, they're very rare, maybe 1 to 5% of people that we meet with, they're actually already optimizing their property. Like I said, this is pretty rare. Very few property owners are actually optimizing the performance of their property on their own. And sometimes you might find out that you actually can't improve the performance of their property. Like I said though, 95% of the time that you meet with a property owner, that is far from the case. And so I'm gonna link below to a tool called the Profitability Projection Tool that I put together. You can download that, you can use that, and you can use it to get data from your area, wherever you wanna manage properties, because you can do this remotely. Wherever you wanna manage properties, you can get the data for that area and use this Profitability Projection Tool to show a property owner exactly how much their property could and should be earning on average over a 12-month period. It'll show them all the seasonal fluctuations, all the highs and lows. It'll break it down for them and it'll actually net out your management fee to show them exactly how much they'll earn net in their pocket at the end of the day. Now, Really simple. You can do this. It's data driven. So it's not just your guesswork or your empty promises that they have to rely on. This is based on data. So I'm going to show you. I'll also link in the description to in the same link where I've got that, you'll be able to download instructions on how to set it up and how to get that data. So it'll be all taken care of. And you can show them based on data how much money they could be earning. And they'll know how much money they're earning right now. So that gap is how much additional income you can be putting in their pocket. That's pretty strong. You can show them that they can be earning more money and that you can do that. And like I said, you're giving them this 3-month trial period to be able to just test it out and see that you can actually do what you're saying you're gonna do. And that comes to our last point that we wanna talk about is how do we actually present this in a way that we can get 80% or more of property owners that we meet with to actually say yes and want us to manage the property right then and there. I'm not talking about waiting months for them to say yes. I want them to get a yes. I want to get a yes right away. And so the way that we do this is by creating what's called an irresistible offer. We want to make an offer that's so good, it doesn't even make any sense for them to say no. It would be illogical for them to say no. Now, in order to do this, it has to actually make sense. That's why I'm not talking about having 100% of property owners say yes to this, because some property owners, it actually won't be in their best interest. And with those property owners, you don't even want to offer to work with them if you know that it's not going to be in their best interest. Let's say you meet with this property owner again. Very, very rare, but you meet with a property owner who absolutely loves hosting. They love every minute that they put into it, and they're already optimizing their returns. Well, naturally, by taking the responsibilities off their plate, it's not gonna actually add any value to them. It doesn't make sense because they really love it, they really enjoy it. And if you can improve their performance, then there's really no reason for them to say yes to you. But for the rest of the world, you know, the 80, the 90% of people that we meet with who we are going to be able to add real value to, it's just a matter of making it an irresistible offer by number one, making the risk very, very, very low and making the return quite high and quite clear and quite surefire, so to speak. And so the way that we do this is by presenting the offer, like I talked about, with a trial period, number one, so that it de-risks it. The worst case scenario for the property owner is that they get their property managed by us for, you know, a couple of weeks or a couple of months, and they end up not being happy with it. We hand it back over to them. Really no skin off their back. Maybe they've lost a 20% management fee if we're charging a 20% management fee for a couple of months, but in exchange for that, they didn't have to do any of the work and they're getting the property back and it's all, and they probably have some more bookings in there anyway from the time that we've managed it. So it's really net zero. It doesn't end up being much risk at all for the property owner. The worst case scenario is really quite little. And the best case scenario is that we do a phenomenal job. They've got it all taken off their plate and they're earning more money. Total win-win. Right? So de-risking it and then making the return opportunity really high for them. So you want to take away the risk and increase the reward. And it's not about blowing the reward up. So I highly recommend that you stay conservative. I actually recommend staying not realistic, but conservative in our estimates of what we can bring in on a property if you're presenting it to them and you're using this profitability projection tool, but really having the confidence to know your numbers and to have data driving it means that it's not, you know, a gamble for them. It's not, okay, well, you know, I have a 1 in 10 chance or a 50-50 chance of making a great return. They have a really good, you know, 80, 90, 100% chance in some cases of making this a better return because we know we can improve the performance and we know we can hit these bare minimums. So if we keep that conservative, we're gonna oftentimes still be able to show them using that profitability projection tool that we can help them to earn more money, but we can do it with such confidence that we know our numbers are gonna come true. We know that that's gonna be caused and that's gonna be the result because number one, it's based on data. It's not based on guesswork. And number two, it's being conservative. And so by doing that, now suddenly it's a very low risk, high reward scenario for a property owner. And that's what makes an irresistible offer. That's what makes it a total no-brainer. And if you have the right system, the right structure to that meeting to be able to show them all that really effectively and actually implement on that at a high level, suddenly you're gonna have clients that are gonna stay with you for a long time and you're gonna be having clients coming to you. And this is the situation a lot of, you know, myself and a lot of my clients end up in, is that we actually, the limit to our growth isn't the number of people that are saying yes to us, it's the bandwidth with which we can take those properties on. So my client Ray, who I was just talking to a little while ago, you know, mentioned, hey, we're already onboarding 10 properties for the new year. It was back in January that I talked to him. They're already bringing on 5, 10 new properties every time I talk with them. And the limit to their growth he's not doing any outreach. He's not, you know, setting up these appointments with property owners and going out of his way to do it. He's getting traffic through referrals now because he's doing a great job for the property owners he does work with. And the limit to his growth is just how quickly he can actually get the property set up and listed on Airbnb. So I hope this has been really helpful. If you want to learn more about the step-by-step of everything, really all the ins and outs of this business, how to earn a full-time income managing properties on Airbnb, and learn, you know, get access to my script, get access to everything that I talk about with property owners, exact step-by-steps, everything, I've linked below to a free training in the description that walks you through absolutely everything. The training is insane. I'm giving away completely free for you guys. Trust me when I say this is an insane training. It is amazing. It walks you everything step by step. So if you really want to get some more structure to this and you want to learn more of the other aspects of the business, then check out the free training that I've linked below in this video for more. Again, I've also linked to a couple other resources that are going to be really helpful for you in just getting started in the description below. So check those out as well. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and please subscribe. Subscribing helps me out tremendously. Giving that thumbs up helps me out tremendously, so please do so. I hope you've gotten a lot from this video. And if you want to check out more videos about Airbnb, then I'm gonna be releasing videos every single week that are gonna talk all about the ins and outs of Airbnb, how you can make money on Airbnb, whether you own a property or that you're managing them, all that stuff. So make sure that you subscribe to get access to more of that great content. We'll see you in the next video.